So as we embark on a historically dangerous month with markets near all-time highs, what could go wrong? Canaccord Genuity's chief market strategist Tony Dwyer is over at the Plaza with just that. Tony, take it away.
Well, Mel, it's really interesting because people are talking about the September swoon, just like we're going to have sell in May and go away. And that didn't work out because the earnings are so dramatically positive, up over 25%. And really, in both the first two quarters, probably going to be that way in the third quarter. So when we're asked constantly what could go wrong, for us as an intermediate term strategist, it's you get an inflation spike. And when inflation spikes, interest rates tend to spike. And when interest rate tends to spike, you get credit deterioration. In a levered economy, it's very hard to have a credit crisis if there's no stress in the credit market. And right now, we don't have an inflation spike. The inflation break-evens for the next 5 years, what the market expects inflation to do, has actually come down 15 basis points over the course of the last couple of months. Credit is the credit stress indicators by the Fed. They're as low as they've been in years, historically low. And growth slowing is not an option right now. We have the ISM report that came out this morning showed some pretty dramatic upside. It hit a high of the cycle. And why that's important is that we found over the last 50 years, when the ISM manufacturing index hit the high of the cycle, there wasn't a recession for a median 34 months. So that's what I'm basically saying is, you shouldn't have a recession for a number of years. You can see it here. The peak of the cycle was there. The peak of the cycle was there. The peak of the cycle was there. Those are nowhere near the recession indicators, which are in the gray shaded areas, Mel.
I think Tony comes over, right? I mean, is
sure,
that
a question?
That kind of, well, that okay, kind Tony, of come on chart, over. Michelle, bring the chair in.
Awesome. Come on.
Double duty for Michelle.
Hey, guys. I still am trying to get over the whole Garanimals with Guy thing.
It's fantastic.
You can't
makes your life so easy.
Are you surprised?
To learn that news? I almost couldn't go
it's
on.
It's very unfair to our viewers. Okay, so we're talking about the coming of a recession. That doesn't necessarily mean that stocks won't top out sooner than when the recession comes. So you're saying the recession might not come for months and months and months.
Years.
We could see years. We could see a peak in the stock market way before that.
A peak, not
a
the peak.
Peak.
See,
okay.
The problem that investors have is what happens is you think everything's fine, market goes down 5%. You start screaming that you're going to be in trouble, and then you start to sell into the weakness because you're scared that you've made the peak of the cycle. That is, as many of you know, that's the mistake. Selling into weakness, unless you have an inversion of the yield curve and a clear identification of a recession, is a mistake. I mean, we've all been doing this a while. Think of any correction that's outside of a recessionary environment in your career, should you have bought it or sold it?
So
you absolutely should have bought
it. So here's my question. Does a sell-off create a recession, or does a recession create the sell-off? And I ask this because consumer confidence, to me, is just an overlay of the S&P 500. And if you look,
it's
they both go
indicator.
Up in tandem. So if the stock market were to sell off and scare people and their consumer confidence goes down, does a sell-off in the stock market cause a recession or vice versa?
It has nothing to do with either, Guy. It has to do with a shutdown of credit. People keep talking about an inversion of the yield curve because it's focused on, and it may mean that it doesn't work this cycle. That's what causes a recession. If a bank gets money at less than what they lend it for, they're going to make a loan. If a bank gets money at a higher rate than they can lend it for, they're not going to make the loan. It's math. So in this case, Guy, you have not just consumer confidence at a historic high, NFIB, small business confidence, is at the high of the cycle, and now you have the ISM manufacturing index, which is a survey of manufacturers, at the high of the cycle. So it's not just one.
But back to Earth, Wind & Fire, who played on the beach in Quag yesterday, by the way. So I actually heard them live yesterday.
This song?
Yes, absolutely.
Wow.
So let me take a night. So, Tony, after the lovin's gone, what used to be right is wrong. So the global economy isn't doing so well.
Correct.
That was the whole reason we were so fired up. If you looked at the PMIs that came out yesterday across Europe and China and even Japan, export orders, new orders were near two-year lows. And everything you hear from this part of the world or those parts of the world is awful.
And we know that, Timothy, earlier this year, when we entered the year, and I was
Timothy, that's
my son's name. You are in trouble.
Great name.
So basically, we entered the year, and everybody was talking about a global synchronized recovery and how that was going to spell gains for the rest of time. We were cautious back then. We called for a correction, and it was because when the Fed raises interest rates and global monetary policy is less accommodative, you're going to have slower growth. Again, it comes down to money availability. Mm-hmm. That doesn't mean the cycle's over. If you thought about that from 1996 to 2000, that would have been an absolute disaster. You were in the Asian economic crisis, Russian debt default, high valuations. All the arguments of today would have decimated you as a portfolio manager or investor if you got out of the market. So what happens is you get a huge surge in volatility at times that you want to buy. So that really is our case in point, is when you get to an extreme overbought, maybe you don't chase the next tick. You absolutely do not want to ever, 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 ever sell weakness when you're not in a recessionary outlook environment, and we are not, okay, based on every indicator that we follow.